Bristol Community College Bayhawks versus Massasoit Community College.
All right, welcome in, everybody, to Bishop Connolly High School here in Fall River, Massachusetts, as we get set for this NJCAA Region 21 with your home team, Bristol Community College Bayhawks, and the visiting Massasoit Community College Warriors. Hi, I'm David Cadozo. I'm along here with Craig Salvatore as the Bayhawks come into this game with a 5-2 record, 5-1 in Region 21 as they go against their rival up Route 24. They come in 5-3, 4-2 in Region 21, so just a game behind BCC. BCC is led by Danny Mendez, who has won their leading scorers, averaging about 17 points a game. And Massasoit Community College, they come in here led by Mike Ward. They're led by Mike Ward, who's averaging 22.9 a game. How's it going there, Craig? We're getting ready for this big matchup here at the beginning of December between these two rivals.
Well, big is right. You can see the sizes between both of these teams. A lot of tall guys here as we get ready for tip-off.
Yeah, I was walking down there during warm-ups, and Massasoit definitely big. Kevin Desire to leap for BCC. BCC starting lineup goes like this. The center, Kevin Desire, number one. At point guard, Danny Mendez, number 13. Quincy Pope, another guard.
Like Chad how quick Gia, Desire was.
Number 10. And number 14, sophomore forward Armani Baker. There's a jumper. And just like that, BCC's on the board on their first possession. Quincy Pope, the freshman from Acushnet, Mass. BCC benched into it. Massasoit Community College again. They are Massasoit located in Brockton, Massachusetts, about 25 miles down the road. That's number 34, Whelan. Hook shot, nice strong move.
Good use of the body there, able to sink it in for two.
Oh yeah, he's a beast. That's Mike Ward, that's their 6'4" center. He's their go-to.
Danny Mendez trying to make a play.
Chad and Gia tees up for three. That's good. That's how BCC is going to beat Massasoit today. They're going to hit them outside shots. They lead early on. And they get a trap. They definitely going to use that trap. Armani Baker coming away with the basketball. On the drive on the other end. In the lane. Jump shot. Quincy Pope can't get it to go, but he'll go to the line.
Be a foul on number 23, Brian Tavares, right there.
Massasoit just thick. They got big boys, but they're not just long. They're thick. Quincy Pope drains the first one. Massasoit with a big roster, too.
Well, as we saw,
they got 15 guys on this roster.
As we saw from the first game, the girls' game, big roster can really make a difference.
Definitely can, but BCC, they don't have one guy on their bench. I mean, they get a handful of players they can go to. BCC, they like to pressure the basketball man-to-man. That's what they're doing.
Look at Mike Ward just stop Danny Mendez in his tracks.
Stephen McCall getting pressured in the corner there. Ooh, inside on the block, number 33. Kicking it back out. Deep three, number 24, no good. That's going to come up short.
Ooh.
Giovanni Harper-Lopez.
They're going to call the foul on Brian Tavares. Tavares hit the ground really hard. He's limping off and he'll be taken out. I thought he hit his head. You could hear the smack on the hardwood.
Brian Tavares, 5'11" freshman from Rockland, Mass. Bringing the ball up for BCC. That's Daniel Mendez. Dan Mendez, sophomore from Providence.
Thought about putting that one up.
Desire gets it underneath. Knocked away. Nice defensive play by to Mike Ward. McCall gets it down inside to number 34 with the corner jumper, and it's good. That's Giovanni Hopper-Lopez.
So a big Mike Ward, not just a big body, able to shoot too.
Definitely can. Mendes from the elbow, jumper, it's good.
It doesn't matter how tall you are when you can just throw it over their heads like that.
BCC definitely need a big game for Mendes today, one of their top scorers. Lopez with the handle, top of the key, jumper, it's good. Giovanni Hopper-Lopez. Forward, 6'5" with handle. So Massasoit with some big guys, but not just big guys. They got big guys that got some handle. Desire with the miss, but the follow by Armani Baker. Armani Baker's good for that with those offensive rebounds. 11-6, the home team.
Tell you, that's what you need. You need a guy who can do
nice
that.
Nice play by Desire. Desire with a good defensive play. Going back the other way. Nice block.
Andrew Groh made a big mistake there trying to go for it instead of letting it go out of bounds. This allows the Bayhawks to get the ball.
Craig, what do you see so far as early on? Massasoit with obviously with the size advantage, but BCC, they got a five-point lead here.
Well, BCC, they're a lot quicker than they are. And seeing a lot of great passing, a lot of good faking out, just good shots taken. Massasoit, they have the size, but like you said, it's thick size. Like they're definitely thicker. Whereas we got a lot of lean guys on BCC. They're able to maneuver very well.
Lean and athletic. Well, Massasoit's got big guys that definitely got some game, got some handle underneath, working them.
And Lopez has pink shoes.
Well, they got like Quincy Pope taking the ball coast to coast, off the glass and in, gets the foul, goes to the line. Pope
making Massasoit his bishop right now.
At Bishop Conley, no less.
See, it all comes together.
Making his bishop. BCC plays their home games right here at Bishop Conley High School, right next door to the campus, the beautiful campus of Bristol Community College. All right, Quincy Pope trying to make it a three-point play. We've only played a few minutes here. Three-point play by the Q, the Pope.
Oh, that is his six of the quarter. His third from the line.
Oh, Stephen McCall loses the basketball. Then he gets it back.
Mendes.
Oh, Lopez, a deep three, no good. Up high for the rebound is Armani Baker. Boy, he plays bigger than his size. I'll tell you that.
That is, he's got ups.
Definitely got ups. Oh, nice. Mendes getting into the lane. I like how BCC's being aggressive.
Well, yeah, you see Danny Mendes, just no regard for his body. He goes flying into the paint. And they're calling the foul on Mike Ward.
So that's the first foul on Ward. If they can get him out of the game, that would be huge. Number 21 checking into the game. Number
that
21.
Is Mackenzie Ryan for the Warriors.
And Mendes will sink that.
Sinks his first two. He's perfect from the line.
How about that? So BCC coming out with energy and taking a 16-6 lead. And Craig, I've talked to Rob Delu in the past. I talked to him the last time. BCC had a home game, and I was on the call. And he said that we really have a tough time getting off to a good start because we don't show good energy in warm-ups. We just don't have the energy at the beginning of the ball games. This has been totally different. They've been revved up from the start. They've been revved up for warm-ups, and they've really been, you know, you could tell they're really up for this game.
Well, remember the last time we were here together, it was their season opener, and they just weren't taking shots, and when they were missing. This is a completely new team. They're making pretty much every shot they are taking, and if they're not making the shot, they're getting the rebounds. You see Baker jumping way up above everyone, getting the rebound, able to tip it in. So
well, definitely,
it's a completely new shooting team. Danny Mendes, like you said, averaging 17 points a game, and he's on the fast track to doing that again.
Definitely been one of the bright stars here in the early season. Going in there, another left hand, nice play, and muscling up. flexing his muscles, Mackenzie Ryan, who just came off the bench. And he'll go to the line to try to complete the three-point play here. Massasoit has four team fouls. That's the first foul for BCC.
A little miscommunication there, same team.
Yep, and here's Mendez. Mendez kicking it back out to Pope. Pope cross court to Angia. Angia for the three. It's good.
Angia with the three.
Chad Anguilla, who has been more of a role sort of bench player, he's in the starting lineup today, and for good purpose. He's been playing well as of late.
He's made both of his three-pointers, 6 points right now.
Oh, they get the basket.
Look at that. Good job trapping Andrew Groh right there. Can't do anything about it. You know, it doesn't matter how tall you are. When you got two guys right up against you like that, you just can't get rid of the ball.
And that's what BCC does. They force you to, they force you to make bad decisions. Or they force that. They force you to take that. They force you to do they force you to take bad shots, or they force you to shoot the ball at the end of the shot clock, which usually isn't always the best shot.
Nope, they're making you nervous. That's what they're doing.
That's what they do.
Playing very aggressive.
They rowdy you. That's the whole thing. They try to rowdy you. It's all about their defensive play. Trying to get inside to Ward. They can't do it. And there's going to be a travel. Number 33, Andrew Groh.
The man with the most fitting name, as he is a tall boy.
Andrew Groh with a travel. He's 6'3".
Looked like Danny Mendez didn't even notice the ball was right next to him, just casually walking beside it. It's kind of funny.
Mendez on the drive. Ooh, gets it to the lane. Puts it up with the left hand. Oh, good. Rebounded by Ward. McCall with the basketball. Ward at the top. Here's Groh. Gets it back to a cutting Ward. Ward flings it up there, but no good.
Looks like a fish out of 11. Water. It's like a fish out of water with that shot. Just didn't know what to do.
Coach Rob Dale Liu calling out instructions.
Shot clock winding down.
Here's Mendez. Quincy Pope trying to get inside to Mercado. Left-hand jumper, no good.
In and out, so close.
Rebounded by Lopez. Lopez loses control of it. Back out to Ward. Ward gets it inside to Groh. The big men passing the ball to each other. Groh gets the foul.
You can see that Groh, he looked a little disappointed. He got the foul on that. Perhaps he's not the best shooter in the world.
All right, Groh. Groh hits the first free throw, hits the second.
Interesting
shot, but
it's
working. 13:45 left to play here. We're just getting started. We're just getting rolling here. 19-10. This looks to be a barn burner, as these games usually are for the BCC men's basketball team here at home. And who are they going to call? They're going to call that away from the basketball. They're going to call that on Jose Mercado. Looks to be a moving pick.
Must have been, as it's his first and the third for the team.
Oh, that pass. Errant pass there by McKenzie. McKenzie Ryan throws that pass way into the backcourt.
Stephen McCall just disappointed as he knew he couldn't do anything about that. Thing was coming at you fast, like a fastball.
Like a fastball.
Not baseball.
Ooh, that ball deflected. Inbound pass knocked away by Mackenzie Ryan.
I also realized that fast as a fastball is probably the most redundant thing I've said today.
Fast like a fastball.
Yeah.
Nick Loriano is going to come in for the big man, Andrew Groh. Matt Sawyer in zone. Three-pointer by Angia. This time it doesn't go. Rebounded by Mackenzie Ryan. Gets it out to his point guard, McCall.
You can see how he knew he wasn't going to make that. He quickly went to try to get his own rebound. And you see a lot of guys, they'll just wait back and hope for the best. But he actually realized it and went for it.
Jumper by McCall. No good. Ward stiff. Couldn't get to the ball.
Nice moves by Mendez.
Mercado for three. No good. Desire with the leaping ability. Yes. Desire gets it to go. Desire up high for the rebound and drops it in for the deuce. 21-10. BCC with the trap and Desire gets on the floor.
It's like Desire has it.
Kevin Desire is such an energy player.
And he does. This will be Bayhawks ball. Desire fired up. Good effort there by the Bayhawks center.
So Mike Ward.
Actually, no, it's Massasoit's ball.
It is Massasoit's ball. More wetness on the court. Look at the shoes by Mr. Mike Ward there.
Where is he?
Number 24.
Oh, no, that's – no, number 24, that's –
I'm sorry, Lopez.
Yeah,
sorry.
Lopez. The bright
24
pink.
And 34, getting him confused. That's Javier, that's Lopez.
Don't look much alike, but
Javier
the numbers are close.
Javier Lopez with the pink shoes.
Yeah.
We've seen Silva Moore with the pink shoes, so our pink shoes player here.
Hey, I support it.
Lopez was trying to get it underneath. Going to set off a three. Rims it. No good. Loose ball. McCall with it. Back out. Oh. Desire deflected it. Mercado comes away with it. Mercado taking it to the hole. Looking for the jam, and he'll just lay it in.
Sato just shoved it in his face.
Strong take by Jose Mercado. Mercado looked like he wanted to posterize the Warriors player there.
BCC really good with the and one so far. It seems every time they get fouled, they're still sinking their shots.
Yes, they are. And that's a good thing to see. We've seen Shake. Well, you're just jinxing everybody today.
Yeah, it happens. It doesn't count from the line, I guess.
Lopez into the lane. They're going to call a foul. They're going to call a foul on Kevin Desire, his first. Here's Lopez, pink shoes and all, being guarded by Desire. BCC and man-to-man. Ward gets it off the glass. Kisses it off the glass and in. Mendez pushing it the other way. BCC does not walk the basketball up. They push the basketball up with vengeance. Turnaround jumper by Desire. Rolls up, no good. Rebounded by Baker, strong. Desire high for it, can't get it. McCall comes away with it. Here's Lopez. Oh, trying to get it to Ward. No good there. Desire for the jam. Kevin Desire on the fast break. Jams it home.
Slams it down on him.
Down.
Baker is fourth.
Armani Baker going the other way.
Rebound.
Quincy Pope behind the back. Desire. Ooh.
Oh.
You know Desire wanted that one. You know he wanted that one bad after the jam.
Oh, the great behind-the-back pass by Pope.
Pope showing his passing skill. Deep three. Hero basketball. No good. Massasoit not playing good basketball.
No.
Pope thought about three.
Really thinking about it, too.
Mendez thinks about three and pulls the trigger. Got nothing but glass there, though. Massasoit walking the ball up. You can't do that. I mean, I guess you want it. Massasoit wants to slow the game down, though. Yep. They can't get it to a fast break match because they won't win. Mercado got numbers. Throws it up for Desire. Puts it above the glass.
Oh,
in.
No, you just didn't, Desire.
Kevin Desire.
He's so long and lanky, he can just make plays like that with ease.
Three-pointer is good. Who was that? That happened so quick.
I believe that was Lopez.
Lopez, been teeing him up from up there. Hasn't been shooting a high percentage. Finally gets it to go. Pope the other way. Jumper is good. BCC is shooting at a high clip right now. And they get a 14-point lead. 9:30 to play. What an entertaining game here we got.
That was Pope 6 from the field. He's got 9 altogether this quarter.
Luis Rosario will come in for number 13, Quincy Pope. So Pope will check out of the game. How many points for Pope?
Pope has 9 so far. 6 from the field, 3 from the line.
BCC seems to be spreading it out.
You know, this is what we were talking about in the
McCall.
Girls game.
Didn't we talk about that in the girls game? This
yeah,
is like
we
the
were.
Exact opposite, where Massasoit is relying on 2 or 3 players. BCC has been great moving the ball.
Well, this is just a good, well-fundamental team.
Mercado for 3. Gets Whoa. It. Buries it for 3. Bing, bang, boom. Mercado. 32-17.
It just looks like everyone on this team can shoot no matter who you give the ball.
Right. Whatever we've seen from the women's, where Massasoit, the women's team, they had a deep team where a lot of their girls could shoot, a lot of their girls could score, and they got contributions from about 5 or 6 people. We're seeing that from the BCC men's team. So it's the exact opposite, where Massasoit is relying on 1 or 2 players for points and for contributions. We're seeing it the exact opposite, where the BCC women's team was dominated by Megan Parrish, only a couple players, so.
Yeah, for Massasoit right now, it's Mike Ward and Harper Lopez, who both have 5, and they're leading the team.
And then there's everybody else.
Gross got a couple from the line, and then you got Mackenzie Ryan, who's got 2, and Stephen McCall, who's also got 2. Other than that, it's all donuts across the board.
Yeah, that's tremendous. What a turn of events here in the men's game. Danny Mendez running the point for BCC. Mendez. Chad and Gia for 3. It's good. Boy, it's a rain of 3s for the BCC men's basketball team. And Gia for his 3rd 3 of the game. Am I correct? 35-17.
You are correct. 3 for the game. 9 on the quarter. 9 points, not 9 threes, but that would be amazing.
They'll get it into Ward.
It's like they're calling no shot on that.
I think they're going to call it on Desire. Desire held him as he was getting position in the post, and I think Desire is going to come out here. Number 31, Mason Turner, making his debut in this game. Not for the season, but for this game. He's a freshman forward from right here at Fall River, Massachusetts. Went to school right down the road at Durfee High School. Free throw missed.
Baker with his 5th board of the game. He's leading right now with boards.
Quincy Pope gets it in the corner. Round the perimeter. BCC playing unselfish basketball. Baker's going to lose it, though. Pushing it is McCall.
Just hot out of the pan.
McCall tried to get it down to their big man, tried to get it to Ward, and goes out of bounds. Ward looks stiff out there.
Well, Ward looking stiff?
He just looks stiff. Like he.
I mean, he's so big, he can just throw the body around.
He's not loose.
Oh. Now Massasoit with the miscommunication. Just yelling at each other.
15 on the shot clock. And Gria gets it to Baker where he likes it on that baseline. Takes it towards the middle, though, and puts it up with the glass and in.
Baker, being known as a defensive player, now showing his offensive credentials. He's able to get up there and make the easy bank shot from the paint.
Baker's the leading scorer, and he was a starter on last year's finalist in the Region 21 tournament. They'll lob it in. Andrew Groh puts it above the glass. Strong move.
Shot that
a little
one from under the
but
hoop.
Still strong move, 37-19.
He shot it from directly under the hoop and still got it.
Quincy Pope. Massasoit now is in a Massasoit playing 2-3 zone.
They're calling the foul on McCall, so Pope's going to the line.
Pope's going to the line, and they are in the bonus. Both teams are in the bonus, so both teams will be in a 1-1 situation here. That ball tipped up. The free throw was missed. Baker's going to come away with it. What effort?
Baker, 6 rebound.
Here's Anguilla. Jumper in the corner. That was Mason. Missed it. Pushing it down the other way. Oh, nice move. Puts it up on the glass. Rolls around and in. They'll count the points. Number 3, Omar Jules. Omar Jules with a little stutter step there, as you've seen.
He lays it up for the end one, his first of the game.
Little delay move. He had a burst of speed, kind of slowed it down, and then turned up the accelerator, went to the hole, and lays it up and in. Pretty move by Omar Jules, who connects. Gets the trifecta there. Omar Jules, a 5'11" freshman from Brockton, Mass.
Danny Mendez comes back in for Mason Turner.
So Mendez back in the ball game.
I think they're having more problems with the shot clock.
Shot clock is definitely an enemy. When you come to Bishop Connolly High School, expect that shot clock to be force a lot of delay of games. Armani Baker to inbound, number 14. Gets it into Danny Mendez. 6 minutes here to play here in the first half. BCC has controlled the game thus far. Mendez gets it in the corner.
Steps on and Rosario.
Luis Rosario trying to get too cute there in the corner. It's going to be steps or a double dribble, whatever they called. Here's McCall to Omar Jules. Love the name. Jules, strong to his left. Kick, loses control of the basketball. Mendez, very speedy. He's going to go to the line. And they're going to call a foul on
number 5, that's McCall.
They called the foul on Stephen McCall.
The call on McCall.
McCall and McCall.
Sounds like a bird noise or something.
First free throw was made by Danny Mendez. Dan Mendez, sophomore from Providence, Rhode Island, went to Central High School.
That's
Dan Mendez was also on last year's team that finished number 2 overall in Region 21. Alrighty, so 39-22. Let's see if BCC, if they can put the foot on the throat, because as we've seen, you know, BCC, you know, sometimes they'll have some big leads and they'll let the foot off the throat, they'll let the foot off the gas a little bit, and then the opposing team will crawl back into it. And seeing that happen, you know, more than a handful of times over the last few seasons that I've been a part of BCC basketball, so. Let's see if they can put the accelerator on and kind of prevent any comebacks, you know, by the Warriors.
Yeah, right now, if they keep playing the way they are, I mean, just look at the scoring right now. Is everybody is doing something? It's not just one guy. I mean, Quincy Pope, he's got 9 so far, 6 from the field, 3 from the line. Then you got Chad Nogoy. He's gotten 3 3-pointers so far. Danny Mendez is perfect from the line. He's got 4 from the line along with a 2-pointer. Armani Baker, he only has 4 points, but he's getting so many rebounds. He has 6 right now.
Well, Armani Baker is, I mean, he's got 2 double-doubles on the season. I believe he's averaging around 14, 15 points a game. Again, he's a second-year starter. Kevin Desire, you know, coming into this game, and I'm looking at all these other beefy players from Massasoit, and Kevin Desire has like a slender build. Kevin Desire has held his own underneath there, making some key defensive plays. And
we've seen some nice alley-oops to him. He's able to slam it down.
Yeah.
He's just so lanky, he's able to get around like that.
He's a good athlete. He's an all-state soccer player in Rhode Island. Mike Ward, looks like he's got no legs underneath him right now. Rosario up to Pope, rolls it out to Mendes. Pope going to take that jumper from the elbow, comes up short. Oh, Rosario, the nice hustle play, gets the ball back, and BCC has the ball.
Great steal right there, catching him napping. Really surprising on
zone play
32.
By Massasoit. Cross-court pass. Little dangerous, but gets there. Mendes takes the three, that puts it up. No good. Another offensive rebound. BCC out-hustling Massasoit. Massasoit looks tired.
Pope with a good reach, but they're calling something on him. Yeah, Massasoit definitely, the endurance isn't as good as BCC's right now.
No, BCC is definitely more in shape. I mean, Rob Del Lute doesn't mess around with his preseason program. He's got these guys up there, you know. They start.
These guys like to keep in shape. Every time I'm at the gym, I see at least one of them here, at least one of them there, so. Definitely like to keep it in shape, and they're definitely showing it.
Rob Del Lute is definitely all about conditioning. Mendes is going to come up with a loose basketball. Mendes, gets a block from behind by number 32.
That's Schaefer, and he is mad.
Connor Schaefer, 6'6" freshman from Bourne. I went to Wareham, Massachusetts. This kid went to Bourne High School. That was our rival. That was our over-the-bridge rival there. That was the rivalry. Bourne Canalman, Wareham Vikings. Looking at this roster for Massasoit Community College, who isn't over 6 feet? A couple of players. Everybody's like 6'5", 6'7", 6'6", 6'4", 6'3". Everybody's over 6 foot. Even yeah. Omar Jules is 5'11".
They got 3 people, I believe, are 5'11".
Yeah, you got a few people that are teetering at 6 feet, 5'11", 5'10". The shortest player on the team is Stephen McCall at 5'8", sophomore guard.
Meanwhile, Danny Mendes sinks his first technical.
And he makes both of them.
6 from the line.
Who's the technical on?
It was on Schaefer, Connor Schaefer. He slammed it down when he got the block, but he was mad it went out of bounds on him. And now he's just he's taking an actual foul shot now.
That's something that you can't let happen. I mean, that's just a little tiny play in the game. He made a great effort with the block. Great come from behind block, and then it went out of bounds. You can't slam the basketball. I mean, that's just the one, you know, you made the block.
He was just mad it went out on him, which granted, if you're usually blocking it, it's kind of surprised.
A lot of times if you're blocking the basketball, though, it's going to go out of bounds.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, unless you're like Wilt Chamberlain and you're blocking the ball and then grabbing it at the same time, or you're like Bill Russell or something.
Yeah. Danny Mendes is like a kid in a candy shop with these free throws.
Here's Lopez, looking to drive, takes it in. He's going to do more of that, but he can't connect. It's Baker with the rebound.
Number seven
for. Oh, nice pass. Nice little shuffle pass.
Was that Danny Mendes who scored that?
Happened so quick. Everything's happening so quick. Nice shuffle pass there. Was that by Mendes?
I believe that was Mendes.
They'll try to dump it in. I'll tell you what, BCC's doing a great job on Mike Ward. Mike Ward came into this game averaging nearly 23 points a game.
And they're calling a technical.
Another technical. Somebody's getting frustrated out there.
Offensive and a technical.
How many points does Mike Ward have?
Mike Ward, only he has 5, which is tied for leading for the Massasoit team.
And Massasoit only has 22 points.
Yep. Five by Ward, five by Grow, or four by Grow, five by Harper Lopez, two by Kenzie Ryan, two by Stephen McCollin, three by Omar Jules.
Yeah, Mike Ward, who scored 40 points in the Warriors' latest victory over Great Bay. 40 points. Offense has run through him, and he only has five today, so BCC is doing a bang-up job. They're doing a great job on that kid. And he's getting frustrated. He's getting outplayed down there. They're battling him down there, and they're taking him to task, and he hasn't been able to come up to the task himself.
Yeah. Mendez made one of his shots, so that's good for his 12th point of the half.
And Gia, that's his spot. Can't get it to go. Andrew Groh with the rebound.
That's a good saying right there.
Here's Jules, guarded closely by Mendez. BCC loves that man-to-man. The three-pointer, no good. Lopez, awful shot. Awful shot by Lopez.
Baker's just everywhere at once, it seems. No matter where the shot is, he's always there to get it.
He's forcing too many threes. How many threes has he taken versus how many he's made? He's made maybe one or two. He's made maybe one three-pointer.
Lopez has made one three-pointer. I believe he's 1 for 5 on the game.
Unbelievable. He's forcing that shot. That's hero basketball.
Yep, Lopez to BCC. He's Lopez. He can't make a shot right now.
If you were watching the women's game earlier, Massasoit came out on top. They came out victorious in a blowout victory. Right now, the men have the advantage, blowing out the Massasoit Warriors men's team as BCC turns the ball over with a travel. 2:45 left to play in the first half.
See, it was some good around-the-world action, but then just got caught steps on him. And that was Rosario. He's having that problem this game. He's getting all the travel calls.
Pop by Jules. Jumper, no good. High for the rebound is Quincy Pope. BCC is... They've outplayed the Warriors on the boards, much to everybody's surprise.
Yeah, Baker with 8, Pope with 4.
You said 4 rebounds for Pope?
I believe 4.
Yeah, doing a good job getting up there. Angia, alley-oop. Trying to lob it inside to Armani Baker. Couldn't do that against the big Schaefer there.
Mark Monroe with the steal on that one.
Ooh, they'll get inside to the big guy, and he'll muscle it up and in.
Yep.
And that's Mark Monroe. That's a 6'7" freshman. And Gia gets it to go on the other end. That one was laying up on the rim, and then it twinkled down.
He gets his 11th.
Losing the ball. BCC is there. Of course they are. It's Armani Baker. Pope back to Baker. Baker taking it up. Can't get it. Groh comes up with the basketball. Here's Latrell Cartwright seeing his first that little bit of action. Adam DeShellis.
Looks like he wanted to pass it, but just hung on to it.
Shot clock winded down. This is what BCC tries to force, what they want you to do. DeShellis for 3. Off the side of the rim, no good. Jules comes up with it. 3-pointer in the corner is good. That's not good.
Nope.
Going back the other way, off the glass, lays it in. It's Chad and Gia. He's got 15. Fast-paced game.
That it is. A lot of scoring from BCC right now from everybody.
Again, shot clock winded down. This is what BCC forces you to do.
Only 5 seconds. Doesn't look like there's
a guy
open.
Making it tough. They're going to call steps. Seemed like he didn't have control of that. It's Latrell Cartwright. Seemed like on that he couldn't control the pass, and then he was walking with the basketball, so they call a travel.
And it looks like Ryan Stopka will be in for Luis Rosario. Stopka's first time in the game.
Oh, it's Stopka time.
You can't stop the Stopka. Timeout with 10 seconds left. Might as well use them.
Well, 10 seconds left to play here in the first half. I know the Massasoit coach there, he must be begging for this first half to get over. His team being clearly outplayed, 49-27. So the BCC men's basketball team looking to hit their stride as we begin the month of December. Bristol Community College at Massasoit. Playing Massasoit here today. They're at STCC on December 8th. So they don't have a game for another week. And then they have a stretch playing Holyoke here at home. At Roxbury, that should be a tough game on December 15th. And then at Great Bay to finish out their December schedule before the Christmas break. And then they open up January after the Christmas break and play against Bunker Hill. They beat Bunker Hill 93-61 on November 22nd. That was their last game. Alley-oop. Or try to lob it into Baker. And the half will end. Okay, so BCC trying to lob it into Armani Baker. They've done that a couple times here tonight. But anyways, BCC with a great, great first half. 49-27. The Bayhawks lead the Warriors here at the half. So we're going to take a little break here, and then we'll come back with more second half action here as you're watching Bristol Community College Bayhawks basketball. We'll be right back after this.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Bayhawks basketball as we start this second half. Your Bristol Bayhawks lead the Massasoit Warriors 49-27. I'm Craig Salvador, and I'm joined now, and my partner seems to be coming back.
Oh, I'm back.
Yeah, a little late to
the
I'm
back. You know, the women's basketball coach was talking to me for BCC, Aaron Morrell, and he's kind of long-winded, so I am back here in the saddle of David Cardoza with Craig Salvador.
A little tired.
A little tired, yeah.
Yeah, these stairs will kill you.
A little tired from climbing up the mountain here.
Yeah, exactly.
Nice spin move in the lane by the big man. Gets it to go.
That is Connor Schaefer right there.
Yes, sir. They need more of that. If Massasoit is going to work their way into the ball game, they got to slow the game down and get it down into the post to their big guys. Around the perimeter we go. Down underneath, Armani Baker gets it blocked.
Lopez just has to get rid of it.
Mark Monroe with the big block there, knocking down Armani Baker. Here's Stephen McCall being guarded closely by Mendes.
Looks like they caught Desire reaching, might have reached too far.
No Mike Ward here at the beginning of the game. Mike Ward, the big scorer.
No, Mike Ward does have four fouls on him.
Yeah, can't afford to lose him.
Nope.
Little margin for error. Here's Lopez. Let's see if he can kind of calm his game down and stop pulling that trigger too quickly from three-point range. McCall for three. Can't get it to go. Mendes is going to push it the other way. Following him is Lopez, but he uses his body good. Oh, Armani Baker with the rebound and the putback, and he'll go to the line.
Well, the rebounds is what he's been good at. It's number 9 for him as he's going to the line.
Baker cleaning up Mendes' miss. Mendes did a good job of avoiding himself by getting blocked.
Well, he was just off to the races as soon as he got it.
He definitely was. He is like he shot out of a cannon, that kid. Ryan Torres with the basketball being guarded closely by Angia.
Well, just doing too much, losing it.
Too much. He's doing a lot of dribbling and doing a lot of nothing else.
Yep.
McCall now. McCall trying to take it strong, and we're going to see what the call is.
He's calling a foul on Danny Mendes.
Three. 51-29, just underway here. If you're just joining us here at Bishop Connolly High School here in Fall River, Massachusetts. Cross-court pass. Brian Tavares from the wing. No good. Air ball. Rebounded by Desire. Pushing it up is Ngia. Ngia going into the trees there, and they're going to call an offensive foul. They're going to call a charge. Or actually, they're going to call, did they say white 30?
Nope, white 10. That is
on
Chad Ngia.
Okay, that was a charge.
A very blatant one at that, and looks like they might be wanting to wipe up the court again.
Slippery floor. You see a lot of guys going down. You see a lot of guys and gals going down on this court.
Looks like they're calling on Danny Mendez again.
Another foul on him.
Danny Mendez, very aggressive right off the bat.
Very, very aggressive. Almost overly aggressive.
Already, the Bayhawks up to four team fouls.
Monroe inbounds to McCall. McCall sneaks it back out to Mr. Lopez with the floater in the lane. He gets it to fall. Splash. 51-31.
We saw him struggle from three, so seeing him making it from two now.
Massasoit with their hands up with that zone. Three-pointer by Ngia, no good. Coming off. Gets his own rebound. Great hustle play. Jumper's good. From the free throw line. Ngia misses his initial shot. Gets the rebound.
He's up to 16.
Well, BCC is getting all, they're getting to all the loose basketballs. They're all hustling Massasoit right now. Massasoit looks sluggish. Lopez being guarded closely by Pope. Pope in his shorts. That's the defense they play. And there's going to be a foul on Quincy Pope. Pope with a push or a hand check there. Going to be three on him. Kevin Desire will come out and Armani Baker. That's Jose Mercado and number four.
That's Desmond Jernigan.
Desmond Jernigan, freshman from New Bedford. Ball deflected. Mercado comes up with it. Out on the wing is Mendez. Boy, he takes it up to the rack and lays it in. Buzzing like a bee. Going the other way is the big guy. Went up for the jam, but it's way short. Ngia in the corner.
Really surprised
didn't pull the
put
trigger.
It up.
Three-pointer by Mendez from the wing. No good. Rebounded by the big guy, Connor Schaefer. Chance of defense of the BCC bench. McCall, that jumper is way off. Good defense there by Pope, who obviously altered that shot. Andrew Groh will come in
for
Brian Tavares.
Just a little too much English on that shot, just went way left.
A lot of English. A little bit of French, too.
Perhaps some Spanish.
No Spanish. Mark Monroe comes out as well. Number 13, Adam DeShellis is in. He's got the basketball. Lopez thought about it from deep. He's going to take a step. I don't think he was too sure of what he wanted to do there.
No, but what we are sure is Lopez is definitely frustrated.
Been frustrated all game.
Yeah. Well, he's missing threes. He's not getting his calls. Teammates just aren't there for him.
BCC, the more aggressive team. Play. Oh, nice play. Nice pass. Nice pass to a cutting Jernigan. That pass from Devontae Holloway. A little give and go there.
And the foul's on Groh, so Jernigan's going to the line.
First free throw is sunk. First free throw good.
Jernigan didn't play at all during the first half, so we're going to see what he can do now in the second half.
And that's funny because, you know, in other games, Desmond Jernigan's been right out there, so, and has played some pivotal roles in some BCC wins.
Well, at the beginning,
earlier in the season.
Well, at the beginning of this game, we didn't really know how this was going to go, so maybe they wanted to save him in case they needed him late game. Some clutch moments, because we have seen him be a very good player and a good asset to this team. But
and he's one of the, you're right, and he's one of their bigger players. He's a forward slash center.
But now seeing how this game
gets
going.
It down to Groh. And they're going to call a foul, I believe, on Devontae Holloway.
Nope, it's on Jernigan.
On Jernigan.
Yep,
I mean Desmond
four.
Jernigan. All right. Lopez doing a lot of handling that basketball. I mean, Lopez, I'm sorry. DeShellis back out to the top. Lopez looking to break down his opponent. Kicks it back out. DeShellis for three. No good. Rebounded by Jernigan.
Lost it, but good
pushing
recovery.
Pushing it all the way. Jernigan in the lane. Puts it up the glass. Rattles it home. 58-31. BCC. Blowing out Massasoit here. Stutter step. McCall in the lane. Glass. No good. Schaefer trying to come up away with it. Oh, Mercado. Oh, my goodness. That would have been a tremendous play.
Oh, they're
Jernigan
still in it.
Caught it. Put it up reverse. Holloway thought about it. Kicks it back out. Around the perimeter we go. And Gia from the wing. No good. Gets his own shot. Puts it up. No good. On the boards. A tremendous effort on the boards by BCC against the bigger, stronger Massasoit Community College Warriors.
It's like Massasoit just dipped their hands in butter. Like they're getting the hands on the ball, but they just keep slipping out. They can't get a grip on it.
But they're not grabbing it.
No, it's just slipping right out, knocking it perfectly to the BCC players.
Old high school coach always said, don't tip the ball. Get that ball and grab it. Grab it together. You got to have the hands.
You thought with the height advantage that would work for Massasoit, but it's just really not.
Like I said, Massasoit just seems stiff, where the BCC is the more athletic, the more quicker to the basketball team. Where I think Massasoit, they're relying too much on their height, where they're not getting the actual position. They're barely even jumping.
Meanwhile, Stephen McCall breaks his own ankles. Fouls on Devontae Holloway. So Stephen McCall is going to the line.
And BCC just so aggressive. Always got their hands in the cookie jar. Sometimes they come away with fouls because they're always going for the steal. They're always looking for the turnover. Ball tipped up. BCC comes away with it again.
Again with the tips, just not bringing it down. You know, acting like a waitress with all these tips.
Mr. One-liner. Diesel Mercado. Ooh. Here's Holloway. Mercado. Now Soya. Good defensive. Looking for a defensive stop here. They get it underneath. Mercado, that's his shot for three. Lights it up. It's good.
We saw the bench get really in on that one, standing up for him.
Jose, can you see? We got a three.
Is Holloway just running right into Groh? It's like running into a brick wall.
What kind of shot is that? But he nails it.
Was that Lopez?
Lopez pulls that out of his you-know-what. Three-point shot by Lopez.
Been pretty inconsistent with them, but he's able to sink that one.
He'll dump it in to Jernigan. Back out to Mercado for the other. So the other side. Jose, can you see? One, two, three.
Back-to-back three-pointers.
I think that was Groh on the other end. 66-36, 30-point lead, 30-point deficit that the Bayhawks have accumulated over the Warriors. How about Mercado?
Dude, Mercado definitely hot right now.
Quincy Pope, this is one of the better. I gotta say, this is one of the better shooting games I've seen BCC play.
Holloway looks hurt.
On the other end, we got Holloway down. Not sure what happened to him. I believe Armani Baker is going to come in and check in for him.
Now, I was going to say before when Pope went up for that shot, I was kind of surprised he didn't try to pass it back over to Mercado, because Mercado was some hot shooting as of late. Maybe go for his third three-pointer in a row.
But yeah, Mercado's been, he's been hot. Yeah. That's his shot there from the corner and from the wing. He can nail that shot. That's his shot right there, obviously.
Yep, 6 on the half, 11 altogether. All from the field, none from the line.
Balanced scoring for BCC. Let's go up and down their chart. Let's go up and down to the, see how they spread this game out. Because they've been, they got a few players that have really got their hand in the cookie jar, well, doing some good things on the offensive end.
Right now, Danny Mendez, he's at 14. He got most of his from the line at the beginning of the game, the first quarter, first half. He's only got 2 this quarter so far, though, but still got 12 and a half minutes left. And then Desmond Jernigan, just in the game, he quickly got 3. And then going down, Chad Nagoy, he's he had 14 in the first half, and altogether he's got 17. He's really going off now, especially with his threes.
So how many guys in double figures?
Double figures, I believe that is 3 of them right now. And if Baker needs one more, I don't think Baker's in the game right now. Oh, no, he is. He needs one more.
Baker came in for Holloway. Yeah, hopefully Holloway is all right.
He needs one more rebound and 4 more points for a double-double.
And he already has a couple on the season.
Yeah, I'd like to add to them.
He gets another one. He's on his way to being a double-double machine. He is one of their better rebounders, if not their best rebounder.
Yep.
And he's definitely one of their more consistent players when it comes to scoring.
And then you had Quincy Pope. He hasn't scored yet this half, but he had 9 in the first. Really went off to a hot start. He had the first 3 of the game. And then Armani Baker, we already talked about, so close to a double-double. And then Kevin Desire. Kevin Desire, who he only has 6, but he's made some very spectacular plays and played great defense, great rebounding.
Right, he had some points there that really kind of catapulted this whole thing. And some big energy plays. He definitely was part of that early run, which kind of got this game out of proportion. Mercado misses that 3. But underneath the shirt again with the rebound, the offensive putback, and he'll go to the line. BCC tearing it up on the offensive boards. Getting a lot of chances for 3-point plays, too.
Just making it look easy.
So Desmond Jernigan going to the line, looking for another old-fashioned 3-point play for the Bayhawks. Front rims it. Gets his own rebound, can't get it to go.
It's a little high. McCall tripping on himself.
Yeah. Good hustle there by Jernigan, though, to get his own rebound up the. There's Ward, left-handed hook. Ward like an old-school big man in the post doing those old man moves. Left hook, right hook.
Yep. That's what you got to do as a center. You know, you were there to be there in the paint and try to score that way. So Jernigan out, Desire in.
Yep, Kevin Desire back in. Here's Danny Mendez. Massasoit wants to get back in that game. They're going to get more aggressive on defense, going to take more chances. Mendez swings it to Pope to a cutting Desire in the paint. Loses it. Going to be off. Massasoit is going to stay here as Bayhawks basketball. You're watching FR Media here, channel 95 in your dial, Comcast dial.
Oh, nice job there, being able to keep the dribble to get back up. Saw Steph Curry do that the other day.
Here comes Massasoit. Oh, nice move there. Nice move there by Latrell Cartwright going baseline. Puts it up and in with the left hand. Driving to his right. Nice move. Need more of that if you're Massasoit. From the wing, Pope. Side rims it. Rebounded by McCall.
We were talking about BCC scoring. The highest scoring person for Massasoit right now only has 10 points, and that's Harper Lopez.
Ward, can't get it to go. Desire with the rebound. Ward seems to have no legs underneath of him. No explosion.
Ward's also got to be careful. He's got 4 fouls on him.
But, I mean, he's got to be aggressive out there because if he's not, Miles will not even be out there. He's just going to have to hold his breath and hopefully, you know, he won't get that 5th foul.
That's fair enough.
Mendez, jump stop, into the lane. Can't get it to fall, but right there to clean up the mess. To get the rebound and put back is Quincy Pope. Another offensive rebound. Another offensive rebound. Another offensive points off a rebound.
Yep, Pope's up to 11. That's another man up to double points.
Yeah, 70 points already for BCC. Almost halfway through the second half. Here's Dan Mendes. Dribble to his left, kicks it back out. Pope thought about it.
That's a nice bounce pass.
And Mercado will lose it out of bounds.
Something to say about Pope, he's a very good passer. Like, he's getting his bounce passes down, like, just threading the needle, perfectly placed.
He really is, and he's a great slasher to the basket.
He's got the no looks down, too. Like, he'll be looking one way, just throw it the other, and it's perfect.
Right.
You know.
Ward at the top, trying to muscle his way in on the Slater desire, but can't get it to fall. Again, Ward. Not Ward, that's Groh, Andrew Groh this time with the underneath score. And Groh will block on the other end, gets the block on Angia. Angia having a good game too, number 10.
Yep, he is up to 18 points in Angia. Couple,
Ward,
few threes
from
the first.
Free throw line, gets the fall. Maybe he can start heating up, 70-44. Coming up on 9 minutes to play. BCC, these next 3 minutes for them are pivotal. Want to close this game out. Baker underneath, going baseline. That's his, I'll say it before, I'll say it again, that's his bread and butter. The way he positions himself on the baseline.
Yep, Baker's really cooking now.
The Baker man. Ooh, Desire trying to deny Ward. Got out in front of him, but couldn't get the basketball, and Ward will score again. Deflection by Cartwright, trying to save it out of bounds. Save it from going out of bounds, couldn't get it to fall. Getting hot in here from the sweat box.
What do you mean getting?
Yeah, I know. It's already done gut sweat.
It's been got since the first quarter of the girls' game.
Says the guy with the winter knit pom-pom cap. And Gia for three. Baker inside, strong move. Tips it up. Stays with it.
He's 1, 2, 3, fourth time's the charm for Armani Baker.
That is a guy that is just focused.
That is his 10th point. I believe he's just one rebound away from a double-double.
He's a guy that just wouldn't give up on that tip. 74-46. 8-11 to play in this one. Mendes charges right into the teeth of the defense. Gets it blocked. Oh. But underneath is Desmond Jernigan with the rebound and the putback. Good job.
There's no regard for human life on that play. Mendes just bolting out of there like a bullet out of a gun. And then Jernigan just coming up with the points.
If you're the Massasoit head coach, you got to be like, how the hell I got all these 6'4" players, 6'5" players, and I am getting absolutely crushed. I am getting crushed on the boards. BCC with plenty of second chance points, getting to every loose basketball. This has to be their best effort of the season.
I'll tell you, and Dave, that is what speed do.
Yeah. What you? Cartwright, got good handling skills.
Yeah. You haven't seen him a lot in this game, but he is definitely holding his own. He's not number 12.
Sure is. Ward. I mean, McCall, jump stop. Rebound by Ward. Ward getting a lot of points now, but I mean,
he's up to 9.
From the elbow, jumper no good. Desmond Jernigan, he's getting in there. Ward is just like scared to do anything right now.
As Schaefer came down aggressively with that one, just kind of cradling it. Mendes,
Craig, I need you to yell at me.
I need to yell at you.
There you go. Now I can hear you. There you go. Now you're talking.
Okay, who's at the line? Steve McCall. He's taking his first shot. Or maybe it was his second. I wasn't really looking.
Mendes driving to his left, kicks it back out. That's always there for the Bayhawks, and he nails it. And Gia for the trifecta nails it home.
His fourth triple of the game.
Off the penetration, doing Danny Mendes or any of these guys slash Pope, whether it's Pope or Danny Mendes, when these guys are slashing to the hole, the defense is collapsing on them, and they're kicking that pass out to the corner. It's always there.
We've seen a lot of guys just being able to shoot from three right now. Like Mercado, he's got three. We saw Nagoya, he's got four. Pope's got a couple. Just everyone able to shoot threes on this team. Danny Mendes has shown what he can do when he's shooting.
If BCC can hit their shots like this at an alarming rate, I mean, Region 21 better watch out because they got a variety of shooters. They got guys that can make these shots.
Oh, they'll be going to the Great Lakes in no time.
They definitely will be if they can shoot like this. I've seen BCC teams in the past where they've played some hero basketball where they haven't exactly taken the right shot that they need to, the open shot, or create looks for other, or create the proper looks for others. And Gia, deep three, here it is, no good.
I think they're.
BCC wants to claim it to hit the rim. Or do they want to claim that it was an air ball?
I don't know what they're trying
to
claim.
That would have been a shot clock violation. Either way, it's going to be Massasoit's basketball. So Lopez trying to break down, trying to get into the lane. No good. Massasoit is just throwing up prayers. Another three for Angia. No good. It's a three-point contest out there. Mercado to the lane. He drops it in.
Just back to Massasoit again, not being able to just hang on to it. They're just tipping it up.
Yell at me. to 45-49. Tell you what, another reason why it's hard to hear you probably is that BCC benches, they're wicked, they're really loud. You would think there was like 50,000 people here.
Yeah. That they are, maybe just trying to get into Massasoit's head, and if that is, that's really working.
They can't be that much of a puddle. All right, number 32, Connor Schaefer sinking that one. The six foot six freshman from Bourne.
He even shoots like he's done with this game. Like, you see how quick his release was? Like, just from his chest up high, just out real quick.
Yeah, he's got a good little shot there, good little stroke.
Just a lot of
going
no
back
nonsense.
The other end, taking it coast to coast. Pope couldn't connect on that one. Rebounded by Schaefer. Schaefer plays angry. I think it works against him, though.
You know, they always say never hit a man with glasses.
Yeah. Omar Jules, nice entry pass into Ward. And he'll get the foul and the basket. So Ward will go to the line to try to complete the three-point play here.
Yeah, Ward's leading his team with 11 points right now.
Mostly in the second half. And he'll get the three-point play the old-fashioned way. 85-54. Pope kicks it back out to Mercado. Seven on the shot clock. Mercado will pull for three. Bounces out. Nice rebound. Throws it up over his head. Jernigan, nice. He's been great on the offensive boards.
Frontwards, backwards, it doesn't matter. Jernigan's going to sink it.
You got that right. Drive it to his left. Jules. loses it out of bounds. Going to stay right here for Massasoit basketball.
Jernigan's up to 10 points in this half.
Ward no good. Rebounded by Armani Baker. Baker looking to take it coast to coast. And gets it to Mercado. Drops it off to him. He'll lay it in. Baker showing his ball handling the full length of the court. Gets it to the lane. Drops it off to Mercado for the easy score. 89-54. It's been a complete basketball game for BCC.
Just everybody playing well for BCC.
Exactly. Solo by Baker. Baker going to take
the other
end. Bringing the house down. Armani Baker.
Mr. Double-Double with the slam dunk.
What a great game by Armani Baker. Armani Baker gets the steal, shows the burst, gets it into the open floor, stuffs it home. Armani Baker showing all the attributes of his game today. Boy, has he been a force. BC showing they are up for this game. Ward wheels and deals in the paint, but can't get it to go. I tell you what, Mercado gets it blocked by Lopez. Schaefer. Kickball. Kevin Desire will check in. Luis Rosario and Mason Turner will check in for the Bayhawks.
Along
coming
with
in for
Stopka.
Quincy Pope, Armani Baker, and Chad Ngea. I tell you what, Craig, I underestimated BCC going against this bigger, presumably bigger Massasoit team. They really came to play. They hustled. They've out-hustled. They've outworked Massasoit today in the paint. I mean, they really came to play, and they took it to these guys.
We saw the chemistry that the girls' Massasoit team had, and the guys just don't have that chemistry.
They do not. It's BCC that has the chemistry on the men's side today. Unbelievable. And it just goes to show. Desire cutting to the basket gets a block by Schaefer. Not always the size of the dog in the fight, but the size of the fight in the dog. I don't usually like those analogies, but all the time, but it resonates in this game.
Yeah, it does. Jules, I feel like we haven't seen him in a while.
Yeah. BCC just more athletic. Lopez to the lane. Hasn't been his day today.
Bit of an unnecessary fall, if I have to say.
Yeah, only thing good about him has been the pink shoes.
Very, very fashionable.
Very fashionable.
Not sure how it meshes with the green, but, you know.
Well, anything for breast cancer, I definitely support that. Or maybe he just likes pink. I mean, who knows?
Maybe. Something he definitely doesn't like is how inconsistent he's been with his shots. Either draining threes or just missing every time.
I like the look at his game. I like the look of his game, though. I mean, you're talking about a guy who's 6'5", a 6'5" forward that always has the ball in his hands. He's got the ability to hit the outside shot, and he definitely has the handle. He's definitely a guy that can, a 6'5" guy with handle, who's like a swing type of player. He just has, his shot selection has just been very poor today. Desire, bounce pass underneath. Oh, going for the reverse jam on the other side. Jernigan, that would have brought the house down. Boy, has he come in and made an impact. Went for the jam. Can't blame him on that one. That would have been great.
Nope, even the best miss sometimes, just like that, you know.
Coach Rob Del Lue has basically shut it down for the night, I think. I think he's got to be satisfied with his effort. 91 points. 91, 55, 56. That free throw was in by Connor Schaefer. And Schaefer hits both free throws. Gotta like Schaefer's game and his hustle and his length. And being 6'6", he's got some touch on the jumper. He's only a freshman, so he's only a handful of games into his freshman season playing college basketball. So definitely a lot of upside for that kid.
Well, that one just gets away.
Stopper in the game now.
Yep. Schaefer, he has 6 points on the game, 4 from the line, 2 from the field. So definitely doing good with his foul shots.
Yeah. Like you said, he's got a quick release. He's got a good
He's also probably one of the most aggressive guys on that team. You see him, he's the one who, when he grabs it, he really brings it down. He's not afraid to throw the body.
Exactly. Plays angry, like I said.
Mason Turner almost did the splits.
Coming up on 2 minutes left to play here. Only thing that we need to see now, this game is pretty much in the bag, is whether Ryan Stopka is going to score. There's a three. Turner might have had his foot on the line, not sure.
I mean, I saw Ryan Stopka during practice. He was draining threes left and right, and he's ready to do it in the game.
Ryan Stopka from Rochester, Massachusetts. Again, that's in my backyard. I'm from Wareham. Went to Old Colony High School. Ryan Stopka was on last year's team. He's a second-year player, sophomore. And you know that he works hard.
Something I'm a little surprised about from Massasoit is Latrell Cartwright. He's shown just how well he can handle. You see him pretty much just as good with his left hand as he is with his right, but he hasn't been getting a lot of minutes in this game.
Yeah, and he showed me some things with his ball handling skills and his ability to take the ball to the hole. Definitely got some skill there. Rosario, has open lane. And I think Massasoit just gave up. He had open lane, and he took it. Took it to the left. Rosario, 93-57. And this game is way out of hand. Ward using his body. Frustrating day for Mike Ward.
Yeah, frustrating game all in all. He's still leading the team 11. Actually 12 points, Mike Ward is. He's going to the line looking to add a couple more.
Yeah, Mike Ward just looks all out of sorts. Shirt's untucked now.
That's when you know he just doesn't care.
Yeah, exactly. Shirt's untucked. Looks tired. I mean, just look at him at the line right now. I mean, my goodness. Just like got to be an aggravating day. Kevin Desire is like one of those aggravating players. He's been all over him all game, trying to front him, doing everything he can.
Kevin Desire, definitely one of the most underrated guys on this team.
Well, he's one of the leaders. He was in last year's rotation. You know, got considerable time last year. Was on a, like I said, was on a Bayhawks team last year that finished the season on an 11-game win streak and went to the finals of the MCCAC state championship last year, losing to Bunker Hill, and then they lost in the regional final in a game that would have sent them to New York to the national championships if they had to beat Bunker Hill. But they came up short in that one. So that's where BCC is looking to get. They are looking to get to the Great Lakes this time. They're looking to get to Minnesota. And that's the only thing that's eluded Coach Rob Delalu. He's had some pretty good teams here at BCC. They've been in the mix up in Region 21. You know, they're a top team. They're just looking to get over the hump.
You can see Mike Ward, he's just so frustrated, just missing his last 4 free throws, just really slamming it as he's getting ready for one.
Nice block there by Wright. Going back the other way as DeShellis going up high with Desire. Desire definitely altered that shot with his leaping ability. Nice pass by Stopka. Oh, goodness, on the other end.
Man, you could hear it getting loud. You know everyone wanted to see him score.
Yeah, but that was a nice pass by Stopka. Stopka showing good handle, nice pass, nice bounce pass. Jernigan couldn't connect. Stopka getting in there for the rebound. Desire gets the rebound.
Desire around everybody.
Desire looking to take it all the way, passes it. It's going to be a charge. Desire showing a lot of desire out there today.
No, he was just flying for the massive hug right there.
I think he just lost control.
That too.
Yeah. Chad and Gia are going to come in. Passed it too late. Anyways, It's a moot point, 93-58. Time running out on Massasoya. Again, Cartwright, nice take. And that is it. The final score from Bishop Colony High School right down the street from Bristol Community College, 93-60. The BCC Bayhawks victorious, glorious over Massasoya today. So 93-60 is the score. Let's just do our final tallies here before we close it out here from BCC for a great night of basketball. The Bayhawks coming up with the victory here in this one. Coach Rob Del Lou, who got his 100th victory last year on December 10th, here on December 1st, way over that now. So it's been a great, great tenure here for him. Yep. Let's count up those final tallies. Let's tell us who got into double figures for BCC.
Just who got in double figures. It was actually about six players, actually. You got Danny Mendez, who's dropped 14. Desmond Jernigan, who only played in the second quarter, drops 10. Chad Nagia, who he led the team, scored 20. Jose Mercado, 15. Quincy Pope with 11. Then Armani Baker, 12. He got a double-double in this game. Luis Rosario with 2. And then you had Kevin Desire with 6.
So a lot of players contributing in this game. Yep. I mean, a lot of players coming in and contributing at key times in the game. But I think if you're going to give anybody the BCC player of the game or the FR Media player of the game, as much as I like to give it to Armani Baker, because I think he was just a stud in this game, and I think his effort exemplified this effort here today for BCC, you got to give it to Chad Ngea, because he came out the gate just draining threes, and he finished with 20 points. So Chad Ngea is going to be our Bayhawk player of the game.
Well-deserved one.
Well-deserved. So the final score, 93-60 for David Cardoza and Mr. Craig Salvatore. You've been watching Bayhawk basketball here on your Bayhawk Broadcasting Network, FR Media, Channel 95 on your dial. Good night, everybody.